the faster you can act after you've been bitten by a rattlesnake and get to a hospital where you can be evaluated to see if you've actually had venom injected into your tissue, the less damage is going to happen locally. So, you know, what we look for when someone's been bit by a snake is we look for those telltale signs of venom actually being injected into the tissue. And that's, you start getting bruising, you start getting a lot of swelling, and then sometimes you can get abnormalities in your body's ability to form blood clots. Try as best as you can to stay calm. I know it's really, really hard to do if you've been bit by a snake, but the best thing you can do is stay calm, take yourself out of that situation, go back to your car and get to the nearest emergency department where you can be evaluated and see if you need the anti-venom. If you're a parent and your kid gets bit by a snake, pick up your child, carry it out, because the activity of muscles will help the venom spread locally. And the more you exert yourself, the more you will let that venom spread. If you're in an area where you can get to an emergency department quickly, it's probably reasonable for you to drive your child to the emergency department if it's within, you can get there within like less than 30 minutes or so. If it's going to be a much more prolonged transport time, then I would probably call 911 and have an ambulance transport to the nearest emergency department, just so you can get that anti-venom in earlier. So the number one thing that people should avoid when they've been bit by a rattlesnake is applying any sort of tourniquet or constriction device. They likely will increase the amount of local tissue damage that happens from the venom itself. And then the other thing is to not waste your money on those venom extractor devices, because none of them really work that well. They're not going to prevent you from needing anti-venom. They're not going to prevent venom from causing damage to the local tissue. So they're kind of a waste of money. And absolutely, absolutely do not try to suck the venom out. So the biggest precaution that you can take when you're getting ready to go hiking to try to prevent being bit by a rattlesnake is wearing kind of high boots, particularly if you're going through brush in areas where rattlesnakes are known to be around. So if you stay on the maintained trails, you're much more likely to see a snake potentially crossing it. You may hear the snake rattling before you come up on it. It's when people surprise a snake that they're more likely to get bit. Thankfully, due to the availability of anti-venom, you know, there's very few deaths from rattlesnake bites each year. So with appropriate treatment, the risk is very low. If you don't get treatment, then you can start getting into issues where you start spontaneously bleeding and having issues with that, or local tissue destruction, bruising, damage to the extremity that was bit.